Good evening, everyone. This is Mary. And tonight I have a old school collection that I wanted to show you guys. This is something that I was absolutely obsessed with when I was a kid. And when they reissued these when I was an adult, I of course had to indulge in a few of them just for old time's sake. So what I'm talking about are Garbage Pail Kids. So I found this box, and part of it has some old, well, not old, these are not from the 80s, or I think wacky packages may have started in the 70s. These are some that I have. This is a collection of Garbage Pail Kids that I was going to kind of sort through with you today. So I have two different sets. This is a protected little set of my original from the 80s, so 1986. So those are from my childhood. So I have that original set, just random ones. And then these are all reissues. All new ones. So, I thought we could start out. I can show you my set from the 80s. So, the first thing I noticed about these when I went through the new and the old is just like the finish on them. They were very paper. And they actually, there's lots of things about them that are pretty much the same, except the ones, the original ones, had the copyright down here, whereas the new ones do not. And you see how the new ones are shiny? There's sort of a plastic coating on the printing. There really wasn't on the 80s ones. So, I don't have a lot of these anymore, but I used to have so many. Some of these are the duplicates with the alternative names, so I'll try to kind of go through some of those. So we have Spiky Mikey, Horny Hal, Bloated Blair, and I also have Swollen Sue LA. Rudy Toot. These are just goofy. I mean, they're so goofy. I loved these though. I loved them so much. The creative weird kid in me just adored these. Toothless. And as you can see, this is little kid stuff here. On the back of them, there'd be different things. I'd kind of forgotten about this. Wanted for needling patients. Ha ha ha. School nurse. You could fill in the name of your school. We didn't have a school nurse. We had a secretary that would put a band-aid on you. That was her name. Yeah. So, yeah. Let's see what's on the back of these other ones. I've forgotten. I knew, you know, a lot of them have, like, puzzle pieces so that you can make a big, you know, a big picture. And I don't know if I have enough for any of that, but Foxy Francis. They're so weird. Mulba Toast. Alien Ian. And that's just great. Oh, checklist. So this was the fourth series. You can see, oh man, I wish I had Salvatore Dali. There we go. Yep, that was really my bus driver's name is Sam's. I don't even know if that's spelled right. I can remember her yelling at us all the time. Get your hands out of the windows. Outer Space Chase. The alternate. Dale Snail. I filled in on all of them. I was real sure about that. Low Cow. Garbage Pail Cola. Oh, I didn't fill that out. I guess I didn't know any nerds. I was the nerd. Deadly Dudley. I mean, this is just great stuff. Another piece of the puzzle. Turned On Tara. One Drum Cook. I guess I didn't have anything to... I didn't know their names. If I had known their names, I'd probably have somebody on that. Sharpened Sheena. Duncan Pumpkin. Oh, Wise Guy, Garrett, that was a kid in my class, oh my gosh, that fits, it still kind of fits, Bruin Bruno, you are what you eat, oh, this is kind of a, little card that, little profile card for a different character, Sicky Vicky. It's kind of weird that it wouldn't be this guy, but very cool. Diane Dinah. Vanessa Undresser. Oh, another one. Berserk Kirk. Oh, remember that for later. I'm gonna put this one aside. Harry Harriet. Big Brother wanted for see, I had a big brother. I didn't fill this out, so I wasn't an awful kid because I lived with my big brother. And me and my big brother probably both really liked these. He was 8 years older than me. And at the time, I was, let's see, I was like 8 or 9 when these were popular. So he was like 16. So we would have had this in common. I'm sure, I know we both found these hilarious. Screwball Lou. Another Tommy Gun. 1987, so it's a little bit older. Ruby Cube. Hygiene. Oh, let's see. I have no idea. I also could not spell. Let's see. wanted for kidnapping a country boy Stan. I have no idea what I meant by that. And I did not spell country right. This is just funny. I don't know what I was talking about. I don't know who that was, but that's funny. It's funny. I don't know what 8-year-old me was trying to do there. From Malda Heidi. Oh, mechanic. Shorn to Sean. Larry Lips. Another piece of the puzzle. Walt Whitless. Little beatnik. Oh, that's so gross. Russ Puss. Yes. Shaggy Aggie. Russ Puss again. Hip Kip. Unzipped Zack. Which I think is the puzzle on the back. Oh, babysitter. Let's see. Francis. Oh, gosh. That was the only person that was ever even close to a babysitter for me. And she was a neighbor. And a neighbor who I loved very, very much. She was like a grandmother to me. But that's all I knew because we didn't really have babysitters. Rutherford B. Hay. I just really loved the detail. I think that was part of why I loved these so much when I was a kid. Is like, if you just look at the detail of the art, and you know, he's got a little eyeball. They just really completed the scene in these. And I think I found the humor, the puns, and the just, I just, that really resonated with me for some reason. But given the fact that I grew up to go into a creative field, it kind of makes sense that this is the kind of thing that I would like. Whispering Woody. Nikki Hickey. Oh. Librarian. Mrs. McClellan. That was not how you spelled her name. That was a terrible speller. Woody Allen. Oh, another checklist. Let's see. Looks like I did check some of them off. Hank E. Pinky. Ben Triloquist. Basket Casey. Flat Tyler. Trash Tracy. See, this is what I mean about details. You know, you get a plunger leg, another random leg. And another thing that's so funny about this is that I had a Cabbage Patch Kid, but weird little me probably liked Garbage Pail Kids better. But I did have one Cabbage Patch Kid, and I had, like, Cabbage Patch Kid record or something, and I used to like to play the record, but, I mean, so weird. Just weird. Oh, mailman. Didn't know the mailman's name. Incomplete Pete. Dotted Lionel. I mean, that's just clever. This one's kind of neat because it breaks over the name up there. He's cutting himself out. This is neat. And then Tiffany Lamp. We saw an alternate to her earlier. Oh, that one's good. Alien Allen. That's really cool. Yeah, it's a different. Oh, mushroom cook. Mrs. Gibson. I don't remember. I guess I was right. I think I at least spelled it right. Hunted Hunter. Oh, substitute teacher Mrs. Helton. I did spell that right. She was not very nice. She was a former teacher that retired, and she wasn't very nice. So she deserved to get pranked on the back of a garbage pail kid. Hunted Hunter. Brett Vet. Oh, there we go. This is what your completed green border puzzle will look like. Gord Gordon. Plumber. Didn't know any plumbers. Vermalages. Flaky Faye. That's gross. Pet Dog. Spot. We never had a dog named Spot. I don't know, right? That's just random. Dribbling Derek. Tongue-tied Tina. Secondhand Rose. Okay, this was a nickname that my dad had for our mailman. Okay, that's funny. Warren. Bruce Moose. Elwood and Dry Guy. So this is my collection of original 80s Garbage Pail Kids. That was amazing because I actually haven't looked at these in years, and I haven't inspected the back of them in a long time, so my really imaginative filling out of those wanted posters is pretty funny. Not to mention, I'm kind of appalled at how terrible I was at spelling. So, I'll leave those there, and this is the collection of recent Garbage Pail Kids. I don't know what year these came out, I don't know if there's anything on the back, but they are different, and each package would come with one of these foiled stickers, and these were, so I think these were like the throwbacks to the originals. So a lot of things about them are the same, like the peel here, they still had that, they were numbered the same, they still had a poster that they would kind of make on the back, so there's a lot of stuff about them that were the same. Titles are different, so that's one way you can kind of tell. I think I like the old ones much better, but they're still pretty clever. And for a short time there, I got a little nostalgic and just sort of started collecting them again briefly. One thing that I don't like about the new ones is actually the gloss coating, because they make them stick together. But Morgan Organ. Little Teletubbies play there. Garbage Pail Kids. Newsworthy Nick. Jose Souffle. Wet Brett. Let's see. Oh, there's checklist. I do have checklists and stuff too. Another checklist. kind of strange because this one doesn't have that same feeling. This one kind of feels like the old ones. Oh, wait. Oh, these were scratch and sniff. That's what you... I don't know if I want to do that. Do y'all see where that can be scratch and sniff? I don't think I ever did this. Truly. Gotta go, Joe. I'll hold this bag. These were the, this is like a gold foil. So I'll set those aside too. Apparently there was something that you could do online with these. That chant. Another Jose Soufflé rockin' rig. It's like, Osborne. There's the picture would look like the sucker. Stony Tony. It's another scratch and stink. I really don't think I ever did those. I'm gonna keep those aside. So we got Bow and Owen and Heartless Hound. Icky Picky. Number one, Piranha Connor, Piranha Connor, Corny Kid. It's very similar to another one that I pointed out earlier. Even the way that that art is done over the years, it's stayed pretty consistent. I think another thing that's neat about these is, you know, this we wouldn't have had in the 80s, obviously, because there was no Pokemon craze, so. Kind of adapted with the times. So I had several packages of these just because there's so many different puzzle cards to collect. Can't bait. Survivor. I feel a scratch and sniff coming on. Weird because this one feels differently. Oh wait, no, it is. It's a scratch and stick. They're just stuck together. So if I get brave later, I might actually scratch and sniff them. Cranky Frankie. And you know, I say that these were throwbacks, but I don't know. I'm not 100% sure on that one. I'm gonna have to look and see. Rootin' Reuben. Little Barfent Annie. Anna. Britney Spears. Connie Super. I have a lot of these. Blinkin' Blake. Rob. I feel like I remember that one's from the 80s for sure. Keep beat. Scratch and stink. Leaky Lindsay, I remember that one from the 80s for sure. From the 80s as well. Hooked Brook. Lisa Loser. She lost off the island. She was voted off. Jake Blake. Game Over Gary. Messy Tessie. Tori, Gutsy, Nope. That one's funny. Sean. One thing I've noticed about these is they don't have like the work or the little fillable type things like the 80s ones did, which is a shame because that would have been fun. So wow, I have so many of these. Sausage Sam. So apparently there was some kind of game that went with this. Case of the 80s, you just sort of collected them. Oscar La Vista. I do have quite a number of dupes. here's a, these were inserted as kind of a teaser for wacky packages, which I have a lot of, so that might be another video, where I can kind of go through all of those again. Wacky packages are even cooler in a lot of ways, so. Dead Tig. US Smelly Sally and Fishy Fizz. I feel like this might be another scratch and sniff. Yep. I really like how they call them scratch and stink. I'm sure they do. We'll test it out. I'm feeling brave. Mary Henry, Tom and Gale, my love. Justin Timberlake. A little pop culture. Some more wacky packages. See, Sludge Sickle, Coach Motel, and another Mr. Coffin. Oh, yeah, Faithful. Yucky Black Bacon, Dizzy Lizzy, Call it 911, weird. Remember that one from the 80s too. Victoria's Secret. Happy birthday. Candy cake. Cheap Chad. Twice price. Duped. David. Armed Arnie. That's a just direct reference to Arnold Schwarzenegger. So that's pretty much my entire collection of actual cards. So let's go back to these. Like, I've truly never actually done this. I've forgotten that this even existed. So I don't know if you can tell, but there's like a little area there where the scratch and sniff kind of goes. So Erupt and Eric. This is, I don't know if you guys remember, this is like memory lane, but, you know, the scratch and sniff stickers that were really popular in the 80s, so That's amazing, and I'm surprised that they didn't do that back in the 80s, because that would have been popular. Maybe they did. I just don't remember if they did or not. And there's supposed to be a scratch and sniff area on this one. There. Gross, but very similar. That one didn't smell like anything. I think I'm blind for that. Yeah. Oh, no. Gross. It smells like pizza toppings, actually. The other ones that I could actually smelled like the dill pickle sticker from when I was a kid. Let's see. Also smells like dill pickle. So it's like a smell, but it isn't necessarily bad. I mean, this one kind of has a sulfur smell, truly. It's not like the dill pickle one. This one I'm not looking forward to. Let's see. Oh, that one smells like, what I imagine a urinal cake smells like a room deodorizer, like it's trying to smell better, so I guess that's not as bad as it could be, so yeah, we just scratched and sniffed, you guys, I hope you enjoyed that. So, as a kind of a finale, I was going to show you a couple little things that I have, I've recently got as gifts, and these are some Garbage Pail Kid vinyls, and this is Fryin' Ryan, this is Beastie Boyd, that's one of his names anyway, I can't remember his other names, and then I just realized that this is Berserk Kirk. Can you see? This is from the 80s, these are throwbacks from the 80s. But I really love these. They're vinyl. They're painted pretty well. The outside especially. And these are some magnets that I think I got in some of the more recent sets. Breezy Betty and Beastie Boyd. So, I thought that's really cool that I have the vinyl and the card. These were from 2012, the newer releases. So it's kind of my little collection. I wish I had more of what I had from the 80s, but I'm just really happy that this many of them actually survived. So I hope you enjoyed this little trip down memory lane. A lot of this stuff was stuff I haven't seen in a very long time, so it was pretty cool. Maybe next time I'll go through my wacky packages, because they're really, really fun, and there's a lot of pop culture references that are pretty neat. So, I hope you guys enjoyed this, and have a good night.